Yo, what's up, boys? Today, I, your host, Supdograinbarff, am going to be telling you guys a little about the death of an absolute Chad. Seriously, this dude is the type of dude they would make action movies about. Today, we're looking into the mysterious death of Trapper Nelson. So, Vince Trapper Nelson, or Vince Nostalkovich, as he was named, was an American trapper, hunter, and zookeeper slash owner. The dude was born in New Jersey, but later moved to Texas and Mexico until he finally settled in Florida on the Treasure Coast. Before I tell you about the mysterious circumstances surrounding his death, I want to tell you a little about his life. Because his life was more interesting than anything they would teach you in school. Though not much is known about Nelson's childhood, it was known that he was born in Trenton, New Jersey in 1908, and that as a boy, he earned money by trapping animals in the marshes of New Jersey. His parents couldn't speak English very well, so he often assisted them in translation to make sure they weren't taken advantage of. After his mother died and his father remarried, Nelson ran away from home heading west. Hopping freight trains, he made it to Colorado and then somehow Mexico, where he was arrested on suspicion of gun running. After he spent time in jail, Mexico released him for an unknown reason, although Nelson himself was heard saying that he wrecked their food budget. Apparently, this guy had a really big appetite. So after his release, Nelson headed back east with only 10 cents. He made money by gambling with other homeless people until he landed in South Florida, where he, his brother, and his friend John Dykus set up camp. Nelson and his group settled on the beach by Jupiter Inlet in the late 20s, first seen there by Bessie Du Bois, whose family owned a local restaurant. Nelson would frequent the restaurant and would order whole pies and eat them right there in front of them. His appetite was so large that he ate ice cream by the half gallon, and some said that he could eat 18 eggs for breakfast. In December 17th, 1931, Nelson's stepbrother, Charles Nelson, shot their partner, John Dykus, in the back. Nelson was angered by this, so he testified against his brother at the trial for Dykus's murder, putting Charles in prison for 20 years. According to some, Charles vowed to kill Nelson when he got out of jail. Remember this because it's a surprise tool that will help us later. Nelson moved into the woods, and using money he borrowed from his sister, he bought 800 anchors. There he would make a living trapping, hunting, and fishing, and would sell the furs of the animals he hunted. He ate all the meat from what he caught and started rumors that he would eat anything from possums to house cats. He acquired extensive land holdings from bidding in auctions during the Great Depression. One of the people he would often bid against was Judge C.E. Chillingworth, the same judge who handed down his stepbrother's sentence. They became good friends and often hunted together. Since trapping could only provide seasonal income, Nelson came up with an idea, taking advantage of the fact that Florida was a popular tourist destination. He made a zoo on his land called Trapper Nelson's Zoo and Jungle Gardens, which became a hot tourist destination. Tours would often stop there and give the money, well, give some of the money, to Nelson. His zoo became so popular, in fact, that celebrities would go there to see the man wrestle alligators. Nelson would eventually become known as Tarzan of the Loxahatchee and was said to be very handsome. At 6'4", he became known for his romantic exploits. He later married in 1940 to try and escape drafting for World War II, which was unsuccessful. He tore a muscle in his leg while in the military police, so he was transferred from his station in Texas back to Florida, close to his land. After coming back to Florida, Nelson found out his wife had a new lover, so he divorced her and continued picking up women who he bought cars for. He also focused more on his zoo because property values were skyrocketing. Eventually, health inspectors said his zoo was unhygienic, so he put in public bathrooms there. But then the inspectors still said that his zoo was unhygienic, so he was forced to close the zoo. After being forced to close the zoo, Nelson had no income and couldn't pay taxes, so he borrowed $100,000, which is $860,000 today, to pay his taxes. This made him become paranoid about the government, so he put up fences and signs to ward people from his land, as well as keeping a shotgun on him at all times. Nelson then developed stomach pains, probably from cancer, but refused to see a doctor. He let go of all his zoo animals so they wouldn't starve to death because he could no longer care for them. By the 60s, he became so paranoid that he would only let his friends visit him if they sent him a postcard first, and was only seen in town collecting mail from the post office or buying steak. In July 1968, Nelson failed to appear for a planned meeting with a Dubois family, so John Dubois, Bessie Dubois' husband, surveyed Nelson's campsite. Everything seemed okay until John checked Nelson's cabin, where he found old Trapper Nelson lying on the floor, dead. He died from a shotgun blast straight to his chest. His death was ruled a suicide, but many people believe otherwise. In order for you guys to decide what you think, I'm going to tell you the three most common theories of what happened to Nelson. Theory 1, suicide. Trapper Nelson's deteriorating health seemed to greatly affect his mood, and he also became very secluded. Nelson's family believed the suicide story and said that he would rather die than be invalid. There are a few flaws to this theory, though. The first flaw is where Nelson was shot. He shot himself in the chest instead of the head, which is pretty unusual, but his family said that he shot himself in the chest because he thought his face was too handsome, but the angle he was shot at would have been difficult to pull off, shooting yourself in the chest like that with a long shotgun. And seeing as Nelson was 60 and not very flexible, as well as in poor health, many people don't believe that he committed suicide. The court said that he would have to stick the shotgun in the ground, lean over it, and pull the trigger, which, again, would be hard for him to do, seeing as he was old and in poor health. I personally think that he wasn't flexible enough for this, and neither do many other people. Theory 2, he was killed by his brother. Remember how earlier I said that when Charles went to jail, he allegedly vowed to take Nelson's life when he got out? Well, he got out of jail about a week before Nelson died, leaving some speculating that Charles killed Nelson. Charles would have had plenty of time to think on how he would kill Nelson in jail, and would have come up with a plan by the time he got out of jail. I think if this happened, Charles would have drugged Nelson in order to get him woozy and then shot him. This theory is supported by a neighbor of Nelson's and the last person to see Nelson alive, when the neighbor said, and I quote, "I guess it would be possible for someone to sneak up on him. Ordinarily, it would be impossible, but if he were doped up, well, that would be different." That is pretty ominous, not going to lie. I like this theory, but we still have one more to go through. Theory 3, Nelson was killed by the sheriff's office or government. Since Nelson owned a huge amount of land and was not able to keep up with his taxes, it is thought that the sheriff's office was ordered to kill him in order to get his land for a national park Florida had planned. This is supported by the fact that only about 3 months after his death, Nelson's land became part of Jonathan Dickinson's State Park. Nelson might have been right to fear the government, but I personally don't think this theory is true. So in conclusion, while I don't think any of these theories are bad, I'm still undecided what happened. There is definitely more to the story than I had time for in this video, so if you want, my sources are down below. If you made it this far, I would really appreciate a like and a subscribe, and heck, I might go ghost hunting at Nelson Zoo for fun, that would be cool. Make sure to comment which is your favorite theory, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye.